Wednesday night yin yoga. Now, what we're going to do at first, you know what, we're just going to lay on the back at first. So you guys go ahead and do that. If you're here in the studio, whether you're at home, come to your back, lay down, relax. We're going to be laying down or sitting down or on our belly most of the time anyway. I don't want you guys to be able to see me. Now, we're using a couple of props tonight. Right? I'm going to take two blocks and a blanket. If you're at home and you don't have blocks, maybe you have two blankets, maybe you have a little pillow, right? I'll show you different things you can do with them and you can see what you can accommodate with, or I'll tell you what you can do if you're not using any props at all. All right? Right now, just lay on your back. Maybe you've got a blanket under your head or a pillow, or maybe you put it underneath your knees if your back is sensitive. Continuing our little journey through the chakras. So tonight, we're going to work on stuff that's the sixth chakra. That's your third eye, basically. It's right here, right between your eyebrows. And so a lot of stuff tonight, we want to put a little pressure in that spot. I'm giving you right now, just lay on your back, to open everything up. And the third chakra governs intuition. That little voice in the back of your head, your insight, your confidence, your trust in yourself. And that's all about the sixth chakra. Well, the third chakra, which is your power chakra, it's kind of complementary. The intuition chakra, the sixth chakra, right? They go hand in hand. So take your first few moments here, just focus on your breath. Let it start to take over. Now you're not going to control your breath here. I always tell you guys, right? We're just going to notice our breath and observe our breath. Mostly in stillness tonight. All right, somebody's actually joining us. Oh, it's Jen. Hey, Jen. We're a mess tonight, but it's okay. Chakra. I keep saying third chakra. It's not the third chakra, it's the sixth chakra. I say third because it's the third eye, right? Everybody knows it is the third eye chakra. That's why I keep calling it the third chakra. Breaths right here, on our back, letting ourselves relax and arrive. When you're ready, right, we're going to start to move. Now, if you're here in the studio, you can just flip over if you want to. We're going to come to our back, on our back, we're going to come to our belly. Right? So as you come to your belly, now you can bring your head to the top of your mat if you want, or you can just flip over, right? If you're at home, you do what you want. Now, what I want you to do is lay on your belly. Now, maybe you're going to use a block or a blanket for this, or maybe you're not going to use anything at all, right? But you want to get that third eye, right? That spot right between your eyebrows to touch the mat. Right? Sometimes it's nice just with a little blanket. You can make it as thin or as thick as you want. Right? So I'm right here. I'm with these blocks. The way you could do it with a block too, if you wanted to, but then I might put your head up too much, right? So find that place. Back a little bit here, so you can see. All right, now, then from there, you're going to take your hands and just touch your fingertips behind your neck. Right? It's like if you're about to do a couple crunches. Right? Bring them on the back, so we're not doing any crunches. Right? It's usually in here. You let your arms relax to the ground, right? Or to the blankets, or the block. Right here. Come up just so I can talk, right? So I'm not talking to you before, but you guys are still in the same position. Regulations coming at you from all different angles and know what you really should do, right? That's where your intuition comes in. You know, your inner soul, deep in your third eye, what the right thing to do is in any situation. You just have to trust yourself. Allow yourself to do what your intuition is telling you is right. Pressing to a blanket or to the mat. Hips behind the neck, elbows relax. Five more breaths. Push yourself up. Right now, we're just going to push up in the tabletop. All right, and we're going to come. This is called thinker's pose, right? So I'm coming to this tabletop and facing forward. Now, ideally, what you're going to do here, right? You're going to let your hips come back over your heels in a low kneel, and then you're going to lean over. I'm leaning to the right now. Right? You're going to take your left foot, bring your left foot here. So you're just here, right? And you're taking that left elbow to the left knee, or you can take your left hand to your left knee, right? And then you take your right hand to your right knee. And then you take your fingertips and you touch your third eye. Now, if this is a lot for you, right? If low kneel isn't great for you to begin with, right? When we're just in that basic low kneel, what you can do here is kind of lean to the right and just bring that heel in a little bit so your ankle kind of comes back behind, your right ankle comes behind your left knee, and then you're here and you're here. So if this is better for you, come there, right? If you can do it. Where you've got that hip right over your heel, then do that. So now we're pressing those fingertips into the third eye. It's called the thinker's pose because it's kind of like that statue, you know, the thinker. It's like this, I think. But tapping in to that intuition, right? Allowing yourself a moment to think, allowing yourself a moment to just trust yourself. Over and just kick that foot in. Still got that left foot on the ground, still got your left elbow And you're looking with your fingertips to your third eye. Staying all the way in, fingers should come down, and then foot across. We're going to take four more breaths here. Yourself slowly come out, right? You're gonna bring it out. Now, if you're up, right in the full pose, just take yourself again. You're gonna lean over to the right so you can bring that left foot back in, put that left knee back in, and then you're just up right here, right in this low kneel. And then we're gonna bring it to the other side. So, if you can, you keep that left hip right on the left heel, lean over so your left hand comes down, and you're gonna bring that right foot around and just put your right foot on the ground. Right elbow goes to the right knee. Right, and then you take your fingertips to your third eye, left hand on the left knee. Right, again, if that's too much on the left knee, then you're going to let yourself come all the way down to your hip and bring that foot in, right, so that your left ankle is behind your right heel. Here, if you need to be. It's the same positioning with the right hand. Taking 2 minutes here. You're going to come back to that low kneel, if that's open to you, and then from low kneel, right, we're just going to counter everything. We're going to lift it up to a high kneel, right, and then just sweep your hands back behind you. You're going to interlace your hands behind your back, right, and then push your hips forward. Take your chest, your gaze up to the side, push your knuckles towards the ground, and just open everything up, shining that heart to the ceiling. You open yourself up for wisdom. Now, we're going to drop it back down into a tabletop. If your knees are sensitive, right, you might want to put a blanket under your knees now. Right, I'm going to show you what we're going to do here. Okay, so if I'm sensitive, I'm going to put this little blanket underneath my knees. Now, I'm going to walk my hands just a little bit further forward, right? So now I'm letting my hips, I'm kind of like almost in a modified plank here, right? Or you could walk it out that way, modified plank. If you're somewhere in between a modified plank and a tabletop, that's okay, right? But your hands should be in front of your shoulders. And then once you're there, you're going to take your fingertips, turn them around so that they're facing your body. The eyes, your elbows are facing the top of your mat. Okay, we're not going to hold here for 2 minutes. It's a lot. We're going to hold here for about 5 or 6 more breaths. Hold these poses a little bit longer, right? And for each pose, there's a kind of, I want to say it's a mantra, because a mantra is something different, but it's kind of like an affirmation that goes with it, something you should tell yourself while you're here, right? And then this one, what you want to tell yourself is, my life is purposeful. So do things with a purpose. You make things happen. Choose what you do. You have a nice, strong, open sixth chakra to help you guide your choices there. Now, started out talking to these ladies about the remote learning. My son, yes, she has really good teachers this year. But one of them was saying this morning, you know, she was making a joke to the kids. It was early in the morning and the kids all were slow to answer her questions. She's like, have you not all had your coffee this morning? And you know, she was laughing. Of course, they're 9, so they didn't have any coffee. She's like, it's okay. She's like, I want my second cup. I'm good enough. I'm good enough for all of us. But she was saying, you know, she's like, I had to go out and get my coffee this morning. She's like, it was purposeful. So me drinking this coffee is purposeful. And she's right. You know, she's at home. Usually if you drive past your favorite coffee shop on the way to work every morning and you just had a habit, stop there and get your coffee, right? You don't really think in the morning about, do I need my coffee this morning? Do I want to go get coffee? You just do it as a force of habit. And there's a lot of things in life that we do like that. Right? We do them out of habit. We do them because they're easy. We do them because they're there. Being purposeful, really thinking about each thing you're doing, analyzing it, and saying, I want to do this today. Even if it's something you do every day, like yoga or coffee. Teacher, she's saying, you know, I was just driving to school and I just stopped at a habit at the coffee shop and got coffee, that's not purposeful. But because she's sitting there in her house and she didn't have to leave her house to teach her class, but she decided that she wanted coffee anyway, right? So she got her car, drove to the coffee shop, got the coffee, brought it home. It was purposeful. She had to think she really wanted it, if she wanted to take the time to drive. All those things. What if you do buy, drive past your favorite coffee shop, your favorite donut shop, right? Something that you do every day just because it's there. Well, it's not a bad thing if you're doing it, right? But you need to think about it each and every day. Am I doing this because I want to? Because I need to. What's my purpose in it today? And that's what we mean by a purposeful life. It means you're choosing the things that you're doing each and every time you do them. Whether you're choosing to go on a crazy adventure and go skydiving one day, right? You're choosing to stop at the coffee shop on your way to work. Do it with purpose. Swing our legs around in front of us. Great. I'm just going to rock back and forth, right? Maybe shake the legs out a little bit, right? A long time when they were bent in those thinker's poses and then in the passive child's pose. Get nice and comfortable here. Now, we're going to come into a half butterfly forward fold. We're going to do it on each side. We do these a lot, and this because it's a great pose. That's the reason why all the poses, when we do them a lot, it's because they're really great poses and they serve good purpose. Now, the physical purpose of the half butterfly is to stretch the hamstring of the long leg, right? We're going to use it also tonight to stimulate the third eye, the sixth chakra. So you're going to bend your left foot, bring the sole of the left foot against your right inner thigh, right? Now, you can always pad underneath your left knee with a blanket, with a block, if you need to, if it's way up here and that's not comfortable to you. If you can come all the way around, you don't need to. But what we want to do here, right, to stimulate the third eye, as you come forward, right, you want to press that third eye into something. So obviously, if I have great flexibility and I can get my third eye to come all the way down to my knee, then I can do that, right? But for most of us, it doesn't happen like that. So you're going to take a block, maybe, put it on top of your knee so you can be here. You need to stack the blocks on top of each other. Be here, right? Maybe you can do it just with a blanket, right? You can put the blanket on there if you're almost all the way down there. But find somewhere where you've got that third eye, that little pressure on that third eye. You're stimulating it. Now, this is yin, right? It's not a yang class. So you can round out a little bit, right? Usually when we do this at the end of the vinyasa class, I tell you, keep that back nice and flat as you come forward. Here, allow yourself to round out, and again, because it's going to help that third eye get a little lower and get that stimulation, whether it's from the block or the blanket or from your leg. If you don't have a block or a blanket or at home, right, get some pillows in your bed. Stack them up. Right? It doesn't matter if you're all the way up here. Full rest. You're going to take the cushion from your couch and turn it sideways with your headrest. And there's all sorts of different things you can do. Maybe you just take your elbow, put it on your hand like you did in the thinker's pose, and you're here. I'm giving you all the variations. Yeah, when we've got that head supported, right? It's a little bit easier to sink into the pose, to hold it longer than we do in the vinyasa class. It's great if we're coming all the way here with that nice flat back in the vinyasa, because you know we're going to stay there for a minute or less. We're making these longer holds. It's nice to have that support, to feel like nothing's hanging out there in space. So here's your affirmation for this pose, right? That's my intuition. Thank you. other side. Right? So you're going to switch out your legs. Take your left leg, extend it long. Take your right knee, bend into it. Let that right knee fall open. Right? And again, if you need to support the right knee with a blanket or a block, do that. Pillow. Right? Turn your chest towards that left thigh. Now you're coming forward. And again, your goal here is to stimulate the third eye. I can't get down as far from my left leg as I can on my right, right? So I'm not going to come near my knee. If you can get the forehead down to the knee, then that's great. You can use your block. You can use a blanket. If you're almost there, but not quite. Blanket is great. And again, if you don't have any of those, you can always get a big pillow, stack up some pillows, or take your elbow, left elbow to your left knee, and take your thumb or your forefinger to your third eye right here. You can round out here, right? In vinyasa, tuck your chin to your chest, draw that forehead a little lower so you can get that stimulation of the third eye. Okay. 3 minutes here. Plenty of time to let yourself settle in. Here.
Oh, bless you. To a stop. Now we're going to come back to our belly. So this one is kind of a funky pose. I'm going to give you lots of different ways to do it. If you have blocks, right, the easiest thing to do it is to do it with the blocks. They're going to go right in front of you, right? And you're going to lay down again on your belly. Back a little bit here, so you guys can see. All right, and I'm going to put my shoulders on the blocks. So I can lay down each shoulders on the block. And then I'm taking my third eye. If you don't have blocks, you can use a little blanket or a little cushion for each one. If you need to, you can take a blanket in front of you with your head on it, like this. Right. So whatever you want to do. If it's okay with you to let your head come down to the mat, then you should do that. You want the shoulders elevated slightly. Let your palms go face up with your hands on the ground. Your shoulders are supported and your hands are supported. Nothing's hanging out there in space. For this pose is my spiritual vision is clear. I really know we need to be comfortable with our spiritual selves. Whatever religion you follow or don't follow, whatever forces you allow to guide you. Vision is clear.
yoga class, right? And I always tell you guys, if you can come out far enough, that you can use the block, right, as a landing place for your head. If I come out with my block at its highest level, I get that block right to my third eye, and I can come right here. For a lot of people, you guys are all like, huh, I'm not coming anywhere near that block, right? And that's okay. You have lots of options here. You do want to get to a place where you're stimulating that third eye. So it might be the block's in front of you, right? And you're here. This is what you gotta do, this is what you gotta do. Right? You can do it. Maybe your elbows can come to a blanket right here. Maybe you can get stack two blocks on top of each other. And get that third eye to the block, right? It's not about bringing yourself all that far forward, just like when we did those half butterflies, right? You can round out a little bit to push your forehead down. Find somewhere where it's comfortable, where you're stimulating that third eye. But you need to be able to hang out here for the few minutes that we're going to be here. We have one last affirmation for this pose too, right? And that affirmation is, I see the bigger picture. Trust my inner wisdom. You're the only one that sees the big picture of your own life. The only one that has access to that intuition. So you don't need to constantly seek that external validation. It all comes from within. Trust.
onto our back here, right? So take your feet to the top of your mat, and then just let yourself lower down. Let's lower all the way down here. Before we take our Shavasana, we're just going to take a little simple twist each way. So you're going to take your knees into your chest. Let your arms go out wide, like when it's in that T position. Drop your knees over to the right. Take your chin and your gaze to the left. Knees come back up to center. Now you're going to drop your knees to the left and lower to the right. Keep that right shoulder anchored down. You can always make these twists more if you want to by taking your opposite hand and pressing the knees down. Remember at the end, just using it to kind of ring everything out. And last little bit of release. When you're ready here, pull your knees back up to center. Hug them into your chest. Now we're going to set up for our Shavasana here. Right? You're more than welcome to lay flat on your back, like we always do. Right? If you have a towel or something that you can put, a blanket, a shirt, whatever, over your eyes, right? Get that third eye covered, right? Sometimes it's enough to really get that extra little opening of the third eye chakra. Maybe today is the day that you want to roll onto your belly. Bring a blanket or a block in front of you. And stimulate that third eye that way. You can do it without any problems. You just lay on your belly, let that third eye come to the back. Maybe now that's comfortable to you and you want to be in some completely different position. It's all good. Find somewhere where you can be, where you're perfectly comfortable. You're going to be able to stay perfectly still, and most importantly, where your mind is going to be able to go perfectly quiet. Let your breath guide you to that quiet of the mind. You're not controlling it, it's doing its own thing. Observing it. Let it guide you, your breath, to that place. There's nothing left in your mind but you and your breath. When you get there, that's your true quiet of the mind. Thank you.
slowly start to come back into the room. Wiggle your fingers, your toes. Find that in-ear sensation. Come to the quiet mind. If you want to hear, you can take your arms up overhead. Deep body stretch. When finished, you're going to roll over onto your right side. In a fetal position. Take a couple breaths right there. Just reacclimate to our space. And sounds of the room come back to you. Take as long as you need right there. But then when you're ready, only when you're ready, push yourself up to seated. And be able to close here. Right, so let's close with our Tupamari breath and then an Om, right? So inhale, pull that breath in. As we exhale, make that little humming sound in the back of the throat. Stimulates the vagus nerve. It's good for us, right? We're going to do two of those, that's Mari breath. And then we, on the third breath, we'll inhale as we exhale, make that Om sound. Again, also stimulates the vagus nerve, very good for us. So you can join me in the breath, so you can just listen. Well, let's close our eyes here. We'll inhale together. Sharing your energy, your practice with me this evening. Enlighten me and rest in each of you. Namaste. Okay, trust your intuition. All right, I will be back on Saturday this week with a little slow flow. Otherwise, Kelly is going to be here tomorrow with some dance, so you can come join her. And and I'll be back Saturday with slow flow, so come join me. Hope you all have a great rest of the evening. I will see you Saturday. Bye.